in our hometown of Williamsport, Pennsylvania.
When the gas came in here, everything skyrocketed.
A few years ago, this small city in rural north central Pennsylvania became a major hub of Marcellus shale gas drilling. The big influx of workers and small supply of housing drove up prices. Jonathan Williamson chairs the political science department at Lycoming College and serves on Williamsport City Council. He studied the housing issue and says prices have dropped as drilling has slowed down, but not enough for many seniors and people living on low income. It's also been difficult to plan around the cyclical nature of the oil and gas business.
Housing is a kind of a permanent asset for a community or relatively permanent, and so you can't just build it and tear it down on the fly.
In the early days of the boom, Williamson says some people were priced out of their homes by landlords looking for more money.
They're in crisis mode when they're forced out of their home. If they were used to paying $500 or $600 per rent, and they can find nothing in that price range at all, what can they do in the short term?
It was a similar story in the Bakken oil field of North Dakota. The remote region firmly saw rental prices start to look more like Manhattan. As oil prices have fallen, though, so have the rents, says Gene Beter. He's the economic development director for McKenzie County in the heart of North Dakota's drilling zone. But he says housing prices are still far above what many locals would consider normal.
Well, I'll give you an example. Rates were probably $3,000 a month, or down to $1,500 a month. Still a significant shortage of affordable single-family homes.
Beter says drilling began slowing down about 9 months ago, just as more developers were finally starting to build more of those single-family homes. Now they're thinking twice.